Welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games and the first day of short track speed skating. We're here at the Olympic Centre in the 1932 Jack Shea Arena. As I say, we'll be focusing first on the women's 1500 metre race. Each race sees the athletes complete 13 and a half laps of the 111.1 metre oval in what's commonly known as the wait and see event. We'll see athletes conserving energy through the first eight or so laps, but getting themselves in position for an electric sprint finish. Well, the all-important officials are there to look for any infringements. And let me tell you, if this is your first time watching short track speed skating, there are plenty of infringements. Now, I have to tell you that the minus six temperature is great for the athletes out here, but it's pretty chilly in the venue for all the spectators, and you'll see lots of warm coats, scarves and hats being worn. Heat number one of the semi-finals. Ishida taking to the front from Stoddard. Getting a big cheer from the crowd. Zenip Kermakan deciding to overtake Kevilon. Pace picked up now. Kevilon sitting in third place. Gia trying to press Stoddard, but Stoddard stayed out there at the front with three and a half laps to go. They're down to just two, and there's a big fall there. Gia goes down with Vancouver. Stoddard up the front. Stoddard up the front with Gia. It was in fact Ishida that went down by the looks of things. And now in third place, one of the Kazakhs made it through. Oh, there's the bump, and it's Vancouver taking out Kevilon. And I'm not sure that that will go unpunished, and we could see Kevilon go through to the A final. We have to wait, of course, for the judges to make their decision on this one. Penalty, end of straight, inside skater, failure to give way. So Vancouver getting penalized for not giving up the line. And there it is, confirmation. Corinne Stoddard, top of the pile from Gia. We move on to the second semi-final heat. Seidel, Nagamori, Tama, Otter, Kim, Takahashi, and De Boer. Seidel now steps up to the front. Three laps to go as they come around. And they have put the pedal down here. Seidel up front from Latai. And they have really opened this one up. Here comes the Korean. Kim going for things on the bell. Gets up behind Seidel. Kim happy to sit in second position. Doesn't want to expend too much more energy and crosses the line. Seidel and Kim will progress pending a review. Kim left that very late. Getting up the front just after the halfway stage and then staying there. Well, it doesn't look like any penalties have been given at this stage. So Seidel and Kim qualified as the top two finishers in heat number two. They're on the line for heat number three. Olympic champion on your right-hand side, Choi Min-jun, lining up with a teammate in fifth lane, Seo Wee-min. Hal Dode, Akon Wang, and LaMarche completing the lineup of seven. Top two progress to the A final. And Choi took it very easy in the quarterfinal heat. She sat at the back. She was quite happy to wait until right at the very end before using her sprint finish. So just keep an eye on 27. Might get a bit of help from number 31, her teammate, Sia Win-min. Sia is just sitting in front of Choi. So take him to the front. So Catherine LaMarche now dropping out into second, and it's Ha Wei Ying who's stepped up to the front, but look who's coming. Seo Wee-min and Choi Mi-sun. Choi Mi-sun around the outside. Wei and Hao. Oh, it's Hao that's just been overtaken. And Seo just lets Kim go past by the look of things. Acting as a rear gunner here, guarding her off. So three laps to go. And Choi Min-jun getting a little bit of help from her teammate here, acting as a bit of a blocker. So whichever way, whichever route Choi takes, Seo takes the other one. Just holds things up and stays in behind. Seo going wide, getting the bell. So Seo stays tight. Good teamwork here. And it looks to me like the two Koreans are going to team up and go through to the A final. So we have three Koreans in that A final. Kim Jun-hee not getting penalized in the second of the semi-final heats. Just look at them come around the outside. Seo up first. Choi just sitting in behind her, happy to go the longer way round.
We're advancing helmet number 12 to the A final. Helmet 12 to the A final.
Well, there you go. Gwendolyn Dode does benefit from LaMarche's infringement. Mention there that Choi and Seo going through, and Dode getting a promotion to the A final.
Go to the start.
So the men are ready for their first heat of the semi-finals. Jang Lee, Kim, Oschempa, Zhu, Miata, and Aka in the first heat.
Go to the start.
So we're underway. Men's semi-final heat number one. So early start here. Brown and Kim skipping up to the front, and it's Miata Shogo who presses as well, slipping into second place. And now coming around the outside, Furkan Akar from Turkey. He's pressing very hard around the outside, moves up into second place, or not quite. A Japanese athlete just staying in touch. Oh, this is going to be close, and there goes the Korean. The Korean at the bell leads from Brandon Kim of the USA. And what a burst of speed there. Jang Sung-woo easily makes it over the line, and I think on the line, Furkan Akar does it as well. We have to wait for confirmation, but that incredibly late burst of speed from Jang Sunwu, enough to steal first place. Well, it was in fact Zhu Yingding who got done there, coming from the outside illegally, and gets penalised. So the Japanese athlete, Miyata Shogo, gets paraded. Semi-final heat number two. Krasberg, Ganek Metov, Latvia and Kazakhstan. Great Britain's Ethan Treacy, another Kazakh athlete. Shami Karnov, Kim of Korea, starting in fifth. Bontovic of Hungary and Dodan complete the lineup. And it's been spotted by Kim Tae-sung, who has moved into third position. Just sitting behind him is Philippe Dodin from Canada. And looks like the move from Kim is coming early. He saw the Latvian going. He went outside, around the outside of Shami Karnov and on the inside of Krusbergs. What a move from him. Early press here. With near bells in the crowd, there's still three to go. And Kim's decided to take this one by the horns, get out front and then hold off. Krusberg staying with him. And now it's Ganek Metov who's sitting in third with his teammate Shami Karnov dropping down into fourth. So they're on the last lap, Kim looking safe here. Krusberg's well, chasing for the line, that is going to be very close. A little sneaky press to the line from Adil Galiakmetov. Now I wonder who has crossed the line first here. And qualifying for the A final, Kim Tae-sung and Robert Krusberg's Korea and Latvia progress through heat number two of the semi-finals in the men's 1500. Well, we've got one more heat to go. You can see the athletes just warming up. It's Wang of China, Suzu of Japan, Bergeron of Canada, Lee of Korea, Steenhart of the Netherlands, Foucault from France, and Minier from Canada.
Thanks,
go
to the start. Ready. So Quentin Foucault deciding to just spread things out early doors. Steenhoff goes around the outside. He's going to be followed in close order by Minier. But Lecoq holding the inside line. A bit more momentum with Steenhoff. He takes the lead. And Minier coming up the inside of the Frenchman. But around the outside. Lee trying to come up the inside now, switching lines, goes into third ahead of Matsuzu, and now skips ahead of Berrigan taken out, and now the Korean goes up the inside again, slipping up into second place. Steenhart pumping hard here on the last lap, and Steenhart has done the hard work here from the front, and he does qualify along with Lee Jung-min. That was an awful lot of work being done by Bram Steenhart of Utrecht University. And here is the result. It was in fact Steenhart that got dropped by Foucault in there. And Matsuzu and Minier qualify as well to the B final with their results in third and fourth. So Quentin Lecoq and Lee Jung-min through. So now time for the big one. The top seven athletes going head to head for the gold medal here in the 1500 meters at the Lake Placid 2023 World University Games, winter edition. And this 1500 meters is underway in the lineup going to Beijing. In second place at the moment, Corinne Stoddard from Salt Lake City Community College. She went in the 500, 1000 and 1500 meters at the Beijing Olympics. And the German, Anna Seidel, competed in the 1500 meters at those last Winter Olympics. And out the front, Gwendolyn Dode swept all three distances at the national championships in France just a month ago. Then we have a Korean 1-2-3. Choi Min-jun on the outside now. That Seidel goes down. Looks like the Chinese athlete Jia Hu Lin may have been involved in that one. She's trying to get in the mix and comes up the inside. But look at these three Koreans. Choi Min-jun up the front from Seo Wee-min. Jia Hu Lin sitting in third place, but Kim Jun-hee not far behind. 2.5 laps to go here as Choi Min-jun leads her teammate Seo Wee-min, and the third Korean, Kim Kyun-hee, goes into third. And now it's a pure sprint between the three Koreans. Choi Min-jun has the advantage around the final bend, and it's going to be a 1-2-3 for Korea. Well, once they went for it, you can see the Chinese athlete thought, well, there's nothing I can do other than go with them. Now, is that just a fall from Seidel? And maybe that did distract Kim Kyun-hee. So there is confirmation of the women's 1500 meters final. The top three for Korea, Choi Min-jun, from the 2:43.01, from Kim Kyun-hee, the 2:43.82, and Seo Wee-min. Next up, it's the big one, the men's 1500 meter A final. Seen three Koreans win the women's 1500 meters, and there are three Koreans in the lineup here for the men's 1500 meters. So getting out the front early, Kim Tae-sun leading from Brandon Kim. And it's Lee Jung-min who's gone up to the front, but Robert Krisberg's decides he's going to have a little pop at the front. Latvian leading two of the Koreans. Kim Tae-sun pushing in the inside this time, takes the lead back. Sitting in third now is Lee Jung-min. And so with three to go, Kim Tae-sun up the front. Robert Krisberg in second place, but sneaking up around the outside, it's Jang Sung-woo. Jang Sung-woo pushing hard. He goes into the lead, Jang Sung-woo. Jang Sung-woo being overtaken again by Kim Tae-sun. The third Korean stepping up into the top three, and Krisberg has slipped back, and it's a 1-2-3. A 1-2-3 for Korea here. Kim from Lee from Jang in the end, but it was mighty close on the line. You can see that it was Lee who just got the better inside line. He just got pulled wide, Jang. So Kim Tae-sun takes first from Lee Jung-min and Kang Sung-woo. Top three for Korea in the men's 1500. Well, We have confirmation there of the top three finishes. Kreuzberg's putting a good effort, but it's Kim from Lee from Jang in the men's 1500 meters. Korea completing a clean sweep of the medals in the men's and women's 1500 meters here at Lake Placid. So in third place, the Olympic silver medalist from Beijing in the 3000 meter relay in 2022, those Winter Olympic Games, picks up a gold medal in the 1500 meters, representing the Republic of Korea and Korea University. Very specifically, she said, the Sejong campus part of Korea University. Seo Win-min collects her bronze medal. Adi Rondak Mack, the mascot, the moose mascot as well.
Second place and silver medalist representing Republic of Korea, Kim Young-hee.
Well, just doing it on the final bend and sneaking over the line into second place. The silver medal goes to the Kyung-gil University student, also from the Republic of Korea, Kim Young-hee. Also a 3,000 meter specialist, got a gold medal at the second Senior World Cup of the season back in November.
Gold medalist and short track women's 1,500 meter champion, representing Republic of Korea, Choi Min-jong.
Well, you could say she had all the pressure on her. The Olympic gold medalist from Beijing 2022 in the 1500 meters came here as the red hot favorite, representing the Republic of Korea at Korea University, 24-year-old Choi Min-jun. Well, it was a Korean sweep. First up in the bronze medal position, Jang Sung-woo. First place in the 1000 meters, second in the 500 meters at the Winter Youth Olympic Games back in January 2020, gets a bronze at the World University Games of 2023.
Second place and silver medalist representing Republic of Korea, Jongmin Lee.
Also a Winter Youth Olympic medalist, gold in the 500 meters, silver in the 1000 meters back in 2020. He's got a silver here at the 2023 edition of the World University Games. Representing the Republic of Korea and Kyung-gil University, it's Lee Jung-min.
First place, gold medalist and short track men's 1500 meter champion, representing Republic of Korea, Taesung Kim.
Well, he's already won a World Cup, 500 meters back in December, World Cup 3 of the seniors. Now he is the World University Games champion, also from the Republic of Korea. Kyung-hee University student Kim Tae-sun has taken gold in a Korean clean sweep.